Hi, it's Mike and Joey with Gray Fox Realty, and we're bringing you your monthly newsletter. So we've got some exciting things to share with you this month. Hey, this month we want to give shout outs to some folks that really helped us out and grow our business. And we would like to thank Catherine, Adam, Mark, Chris, and Lynn for sending us referrals. We couldn't do it without you, so we appreciate you, and we'll keep the coffee coming.
Yeah, thank you very much, guys. All right, so let's talk a little bit about real estate numbers and statistics. We share those with you every month. This month, we'll highlight a couple interesting things. The absorption rate, or the months of inventory, is still staying about stable. 2.2 months in Franklin, 2.8 in Brentwood. It's elevated. It's in the fours, high fours actually, in Nolensville. And that is due to all of the new construction. Builders are basically stacking the inventory with new construction out there, and that makes it look like it's a little higher. Spring Hill, still really hot market, less than 2 months of inventory there. So that's interesting to note. While we're looking at the numbers, Franklin, the average price of a Franklin home on the market right now is north of $1 million. It's $1,021,000. And Joey and I did a little research to find out why that was. There's 131 properties listed right now in Franklin, north of $1 million, and that's out of 536 homes. So then we started wondering how many of the homes are listed that are below the average selling price. And the average selling price over the last 3 months, $572,000. So we looked that up, and the numbers come in. There is like 196 homes available below the average sales price in Franklin. So if you'd like to know more about how these numbers impact whether you're deciding to sell, deciding to buy, and the price of all that, give us a call. We'd love to help and talk through that with you.
The good news on all that is there's still plenty of opportunity to get a house under $600,000 in Franklin.
At this time of year, we're going to get all this rain coming in. What's some things you can do around the house to help?
Well, there's several things, but one of the easiest DIY fixes for keeping water out of your crawl space is that black corrugated pipe that you see running down homes' downspouts. So real cheap, you can get it at Lowe's, Home Depot, Ace Hardware, attach it to the base of the downspout, direct it away from the house, boom, keep the water out of your house.
Yeah, that is one of the things. A lot of foundation problems and crawl space problems, mold, fungus problems, all come from water in the crawl space.
That's so, it.
Great advice.
You can cover it with mulch or bury it or leave it on top of the ground, whatever you choose.
Thanks very much, guys, for watching. Share this video with anybody you think needs this information and would love to know more about Gray Fox Realty.